See over here, I've got 25 mil, so that gives me 10 mil to stick on at the top, and I think I'd like a little bit more than that. I'd like at least 20 would be enough, so I just need to extend this face. So go out of that, in there, push-pull, which is Q, 25, and we'll extend that up to 35 mil, click OK, and there we're fine. Now, I want to save this, so file, save as. I don't want to overwrite the breathing tube connectors, because I want them as well, they're two separate pieces. Right, if we go into manufacture and we look at the CAD cam here, everything has gone wrong. So, see, our stock from before is not large enough. Needs extending at the bottom, and we can sort that out. So if we go into setup, that's too long. But what we do have to look at here as well, if we just hit Command G, let's see if we can generate all of these as well. So Command G, which will regenerate all the tool paths. This is where there seems to be an issue on this setup here. This one seems fine. So if we see what's going to happen, it's going to face off the top. Going to go on the inside. Now, I think I've got a problem with that. If I go into certainly my adaptive here and have a look at my tool. Number 3, which is 10 mil 2 flute end mil. And I know that the length of the flutes on that is not 35 mil long, which is the distance of that. If I look, fire up the old CNC so that we can have a look. I think I'm going to have to do that in a couple of passes. So, where are we? Hit escape. So, this is going to have to do it in two passes. And this isn't a critical, this is not a critical finish here. It's not a sealing surface. So what we can do is go into there, edit that, go into the passes, multiple depth, let's multiple depth that at maximum wrapping step down, let's do 20. So that's going to do that in two passes. This is going to do this in 15 mil. Let's not leave any stock. Too much tolerance. Right, so that's okay on that one on 10. Now let's go into here. I don't see why this now has stock from there. Thank you. see what we're doing here. Right, so we're now into the second option here, so I've gone into setup 4. So we're going to have to flip the part over in the CNC. Right, so the first problem we've got here is that the actual stock that it thinks we've got there is not big enough. So I think that's going to be 65. So once we've done that, hit Command G or Control G, and then it's going to sort itself out. And if we notice on here, I've set the stock point there. That's my origin. So I'm going to have to zero off the top of the vice jaws when I'm holding. When I flip that upside down and I'm holding it, the zero point there is there. On this first one, the zero point is at the bottom in the middle. So we can deal with that as well. That is not a problem. Right, another thing I want to do is set tolerance. I need to set the tolerance here to be compensation in the control, which basically means that I can adjust on the HASS the tool wear and things like that. So I can adjust on the HASS the tool wear and the tool compensation, and it's going to be more for me when I get down to here so that I can adjust the tightness of the threads, because I've been having a little bit of an issue where my threads have been a little bit tight. So it just means that I have to put the diameter of the tool into the HASS, and then we're flying, we're well away with that. Don't think on an adaptive it doesn't have it. You'll see here it doesn't have it. And that is because on an adaptive it's not a finishing move. So it's a roughing strategy, so it's just taking stock out. It's not finishing it to a final degree, it's just saying take a load of this stock out. And that's there. That's that last bit there, so that's better. That's what I want. So I need to see where the bottom of this is, because it needs to overlap all the way through. The bottom height is under there, so that's perfect offset. Let's take that down minus one. Make sure. Cool. And that, if we go into full setup, so let's see how it looks. So we've got a piece of stock there. Let's let it go. So face off. Finish. Well, so then we need to turn it over in the machine. It's already faced it. It's going to go around it, finish it. That's finishing to the edge of the threads. Now the thread mill's coming in. Perfect. Job done. So she's all set up now, ready to go. All we've got to do is hit cycle start and cut our top, cut our first operation.